Ma'am, do you have any illegal substances on you?
No, that I can explain.
This is really pathetic.
Well, you know what? I've been cheating on you.
With who?
The mailman.
Betty?
With the milkman.
We don't have a milkman.
Hear ye, hear ye. My name is Lady Wadsworth. I built this house in 1855.
What are you talking about?
Sorry, what?
This house was built in 1840, and it's literally right on the cover of the pamphlet. Do you even work here?
What makes you so qualified?
A PhD in American history from Harvard.
Oh.
How dare you pose as me in my own house?
Does everybody see this old-timey looking lady right now? Oh, sorry. Lady Wadsworth was
the absolute classics.
Okay.
Hi, nice to meet you guys.
Nice to meet you. Chicks
flicks. That's hard to say.
Is it?
Chicks flicks. This chicks flicks.
This chicks flicks. It's like a warm-up exercise. This chicks flicks. Flicks. This chicks flicks.
Yeah. I'm a very modern woman.
Well, I do have to also say, Justin, I'm a huge fan of you, so it's really an honor to speak with you today.
Thank you very much. It's an honor to be on the show. It's exciting to talk about this, so thanks for letting us talk about it.
And it's a great film to talk about. I really enjoyed this movie. I thought it was so funny, and this is the kind of film I want to watch right now.
Good. Well, that's what we're hoping. Yeah, we do too. We want to watch movies that make us laugh, and we want fun diversions from, you know, all of that.
Exactly. And they're not making enough of these movies these days anymore.
That's nice to hear. Really nice to hear. Yeah, we grew up watching Odd Couple comedies. We love them. What About Bob and Planes, Trains, and Automobiles. And I always gravitate toward those. I mean, whenever there's an option.
Not to compare our movie to those.
No,
there's
no.
Something inherently arrogant in that, but it definitely inspired us.
Let's say that. Well, in the film, Hannah has to pretend to be or play like Lady Wadsworth and be a tour guide in her home. Mm-hmm. And I was wondering if you guys had to act and dress like someone, either a historical figure or even a living celebrity now, and give a tour guide of their home, who would you choose and why?
That is a really good question.
Can I guess who you would say?
Yeah.
Michael J. Fox or Matthew McConaughey would be fun.
That would be really fun. I'm confident in my impressions of both of them, and also mm-hmm. I bet they have really cool houses.
That's what I was thinking.
Yeah, that's well. I'm trying to guess for you. H. John Benjamin.
Oh yeah, I would.
There's a voice actor named H. John Benjamin who does Archer and Bob's Burgers, and Christian and I do this podcast called Life Is Short, and a lot of people write in and they'll say that he sounds like H. John Benjamin. So that's probably your best impression.
Yeah, I guess so. Well, it's not really an impression.
Actually, I can hear that now that I think about it. And you can do a solid like Michael J. Fox and Matthew McConaughey?
Pretty good. Doc, are you telling me that this is my living room?
That's
right. It's so big. Doc. Thank you.
That's good. Well, the film uses the term classy and lady a lot, and I Hannah's frustrated because she keeps being reminded that she's not those things, but I was wondering, how would you guys define a classy lady?
I thought you were gonna say, what do you know about classy and ladies? That's a good question.
Everybody has their own opinion of that. So
I heard a great story that Ellen Burstyn told about making Alice Doesn't Live Here Anymore, which is such a great movie. But she said she was interviewing Martin Scorsese because he wanted the job, and no one knew who he was at the time, and she had seen this Mean Streets. And so she goes, well, she's like, obviously you're a great filmmaker. She said, what qualifies you to make this movie about a woman, about like a woman's journey to independence and like separating herself from a man? And she said, what do you know about women? And he goes, nothing. I don't know anything about women, but I really want to learn. And she was like, that's a good answer.
So in this analogy, we're Martin Scorsese. We have no business. How would you describe a classy lady? I think that term isn't necessarily a good thing, because in our movie, at least, it's like it represents something that's
kind of repressed.
Yeah, repressed. And like you have to compose yourself a certain way, and you can't be like honest fully.
Well, that's what Christian and I grew up. We had a family friend. My parents had a family friend who was an older, classy lady who was really into like you know, she was very sweet, very lovely woman, but like very into like kind of old fashioned manners and etiquette. And like, this is what a gentleman, they stand up straight and like
elbows off the table.
Yeah. So a lot of that stuff we got from her. And I think to Christian's point, like we wanted both characters to show growth, you know, we wanted them to have somewhere to go. And in Lady Wadsworth's case, it's shedding some of that more proper classy behavior to be a little bit more relaxed and independent, you know, and able to laugh, you know?
Yeah. Yeah. That's good. Yeah. And on that, eventually Lady Wadsworth teaches Hannah how to be a lady. I'm wondering, being that you two are brothers, is there anything you two have taught each other, or either intentionally or through observation?
Oh my God. I mean, easy for me because he's 3 years older. So he taught me like everything I know. I mean, like everything I know about music and movies. I mean, he was like my guide as a kid. So that's question is like,
it's like a spent
God. It's like impossible for me to answer that because it's like everything. He taught me everything.
Well, you teach me about patience and efficiency. And I mean, just in writing and doing this, I feel like I've gotten, I hope, better at self-editing. You make it sound like you're like a, you don't speak. I learn a lot from him. I know a lot about comedy.
That's good. Yeah. Well, in the film, they also mention how ghosts typically stick around because they have unfinished business. So if you two were to die tomorrow, knock on wood.
Knock on wood that we don't.
Yes. Yes. Yeah. But what unfinished business would make you stick around until it got taken care of?
Oh man, that's such a good question.
I have to stick around to see how well our movie does.
Yeah, so, that's true.
Tomorrow wouldn't work out for me.
That
at
would
all.
Suck. Yeah. That would suck to die on the day it comes out, right before it comes out. Yeah, you'd want to see what the box office numbers are. I would want to.
I don't have a lot of unresolved things.
Yeah. I
like any scores to settle.
I love like someone I love in my life. I would like to see them. I don't know if I want to see them happy because that would mean they'd be with somebody else. And I don't know if I want to see, I'd want to know they were going to be happy, but I don't want to see their happiness.
Right.
I don't know. I'd like to see you have kids and stuff like family members. I'd like to see my nephews grow up, I guess. But nothing major, nothing like so-and-so owes me like money or I don't know. Nothing like this. I mean, nothing like, I mean, we talked about that too, not to spoiler alert, like, because that was kind of the device they use in, well, a lot of ghost movies, but definitely in the Patrick Swayze movie. And so we talked about like, well, is this the thing? She needs to let Nia know that, you know, the house was left to her. And so once that's done and she disappears into the light, can we just have her come back? And we were like, well, it's a silly comedy. So yes, we can do whatever we want to do.
That was a spoiler.
It was a major spoiler.
Was
you did. You alerted.
It's fine. But well, like I said, from the beginning, the reason I did love this movie so much was because it was such a great break from everything going on in this world. Wow. It's a hilarious escape. So
that's awesome. Thanks, Susan.
Yeah, no, thank you guys. I mean, but besides this film, what has given you the biggest laugh in the past year?
Oh man! Well, we've all needed laughs.
Probably something on 90 Day Fiance or The Bachelor.
Yes,
or, Bachelor.
I can't think of a specific thing, but probably.
I did a movie, like a vampire movie, and there were some really ridiculous elements of that.
That made you laugh.
That made me laugh. Just shooting it. It was one of those things. It was really the first movie I did post quarantine. You know. And so I think we were all just really like punchy and needed to laugh, but there was stuff in that where I couldn't stop laughing. We laughed so hard with the actress in that movie. I don't know. I think it's being around friends. I think I've laughed actually more. I've just appreciated being able to laugh and being with friends. And we laughed a lot making this movie, I have to say.
Yeah.
You know,
we did. It was really fun to make this movie.
Funny out. And you can, spoiler alert, you can see it in the outtakes.
Yeah, the outtakes are good. Yeah, I mean, this is honestly one of my favorite kinds of the writing. I love the dialogue. It's just I love just it's subtle, just the little things like Melanie would say that you sometimes if you don't pay attention, just like the, especially between you and Melanie, those were some of the best.
So nice.
We really appreciate that. Yeah, it's so nice to hear that.
No, it really is. We worked hard on it, and it's nice. But like we also had, you know, like you said, we had these great actors who were bringing it to life, and. You know, you can write something and think about the script as much as possible, but then once you gotta have to give it up, you have to like let it go. And it was so easy to let it go, knowing that it was in the hands of people like that. And Ryan Phillippe has some of my favorite lines that we didn't write, you know, where he just these throwaways, like he says about the fish at the restaurant. That's some sick
tasting fish. He just came up with that.
It is crazy thing to say. That's some sick tasting fish. I mean, it's like ludicrous, but again, like he does it in such a, they all do it in such a, they're so committed and grounded that we got very lucky.
Yeah, I just mentioning Ryan Phillippe, I still crack up thinking about when you guys cross paths and the.
I love it.
Oh, I love it. Yeah.
What'd you say? I don't know. That was so funny. But I also thought it was hilarious when Hannah and Lady Wadsworth have kind of a silly face. They go back and back on their silly face, mostly because Lady Wadsworth's initial silly face was so funny.
Well, that was a little play on, we always laugh when we see like, you see it with like influencers a lot where they're like, I'm just joking around. And they're just like, that's a silly face where people are self-conscious about their face. So they don't want to actually make like a weird looking face. So that's where that idea came from. But the truth is Judy has such an incredibly malleable face. She has like,
she's like Jim Carrey.
She is. Mm. She is. And in fact, I'd been working with him and I think it was probably, you know, and Melanie is such a great actress, but had a harder time contorting her face. And so she's in life, she's a little bit more like Judy's character, you know, and vice versa. And so Melanie asked me, she's like, well, can you do like a silly face and then I'll just imitate it? So I was I was on the other side of the camera. And so Mel would look at me like doing a face and then she'd like approximate it and look back. It was really funny. But we wanted to see them enjoying each other. That was really important to see the two characters really enjoying each other. And
yeah,
and what better way than just, again, like simple. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. It's a good point. You're right. A lot of times people just do the cute, silly face and not really a silly face.
They don't commit to it.
Yeah. Yeah. You know? No, I just thought it was funny too, because with Ryan Phillippe in it, one of my favorite silly faces is actually from Cruel Intentions when him and,
Selma Blair.
Oh, yeah, that's right. I wonder if that was in our subconscious.
Or maybe. We stole everything.
Yeah, I'm sure.
No. Well, very original.
Ryan's character was definitely a Cruel Intentions adjacent. He was like the grown up
version of that character.
What was his name? Sebastian.
Sebastian. Well, they are wrapping me up, but I could talk to you guys all day.
Likewise.
Thanks,
Susan. This is really fun. This Chick's Flicks was
This Chick's Flicks.
Yeah.
If you insist on pretending to be me, will you allow me to teach you how to be a lady? Okay, just please stop cock blocking me. Cock blocking.
Whoa, what are you, a 13-year-old boy?
These are from the 80s. It's my favorite era of D. A lady should excuse herself, actually.
Did you just come into my room to fart?
It wasn't you. There's a worldwide web of information. They call it the internet.
Son, this property has been in our family for years.
Your performance the last few weeks.
What about it? Over here, we have... Oh, sorry.
Hasn't been good.
He's a total dick. You and that word dick. It's a shortened version of Richard. Yes, I have known many, many dicks in my lifetime.
Oh! You're a smart, confident woman who could do anything she sets her mind to.
You're right. I could do anything you set my mind to.
Close enough.
Whenever I would have guests over, I would offer them tea and sex.
Snacks!
Snacks! He does not look well.
No, he's just a nerd. That's what they look like.
A nerd.